Good morning, students. Today I am here to explain some of the basic points of second chapter of civics, diversity and discrimination. In the first chapter, we have studied about diversity. There are different types of diversities found all over India. There are major differences. First topic, that is differences. In India, we find many differences. 8 major religions in the world, they are found in India. 8 major religions which are found in the world, they are also found in India. These are Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Buddhism, Jainism, Judaism and Zoroastrianism. These 8 major religions, they are found in the world, and all these they are found in India also. More than or about 1600 languages, they are spoken all over India. There are 100 dance forms are found in India. People, they differ from each other in terms of their attitude, opinions, dress, look, talk, feel, eat, etc. These points suggest that there are differences prevailing in India in different on different basis or in different terms. Now, before we understand discrimination, we have to understand the two terms, that is prejudice and stereotype. First, we talk about prejudice. What is meant by prejudice? Prejudice, it means to judge someone negatively or to see someone as inferior. Inferior, it means lower. I repeat, prejudice means to judge someone negatively or to see someone as inferior. How we can explain this prejudice? Take one example. If we think that English is the most important language, it is our opinion, it is our belief that English is the most important language. So due to our belief, we ignore or we do not respect the people using other language than English. So we start judging the people negatively or see them as inferior based on the language they use. Such type of attitude or such type of behavior, that is known as prejudice. I hope you have understood. Once again, I am explaining this example, that if we consider that English is the most important language, and due to this belief, we ignore other languages. So, any person or the group of people using any other language than English, we do not respect them. We consider them as inferior or we judge them negatively. Such type of behavior or such type of belief, that is prejudice. To judge someone negatively or to see someone as inferior, that is prejudice. Next term, that is stereotype. Stereotype, that is to fix people. Stereotype, it means to fix people in one image. To fix people into one image, we create a stereotype. When we fix people into one image, for example, usually we say that boys never cry. So that we have fixed one image for the boys, that boys never cry. Girls, they can easily cry. That we have fixed one image for boys or girls. That is, we have created stereotype. Another example, usually we believe that the villagers, they do not care for their hygiene or health. They are not having, they are not using modern technology, etc. So we have created one image for the villagers in our mind. Such attitude or such belief or such behavior, that is stereotype. I hope you have understood these two terms, prejudice and stereotype. Prejudice, that to judge someone negatively or to see them as inferior. Stereotype, to fix people into one image. By doing this, we create a stereotype. Next point I want to explain in your brief. Next point I want to explain you in brief, that is inequality and discrimination. In the first chapter we have studied inequality. Inequality occurs when a person does not get opportunities and resources in comparison to other person. I repeat, inequality occurs when a person does not get opportunities and resources in comparison to others. Inequality and discrimination. Now this discrimination, it takes place. Discrimination arises due to prejudice and stereotype. Already we have studied what is meant by prejudice and what is meant by stereotype. If we look, if we understand both the terms, we can come to know that due to this prejudice and stereotype, we create discrimination. Or this both gives birth to discrimination. When we judge someone negatively, that time our attitude, our behavior, our action will be changed in terms of that person. So we start discriminating that person. In the same way, when we fix people into one image, then we act accordingly. We behave accordingly. So that also gives birth to discrimination. In India, since time and immemorial, discrimination, it has been found, that is based on religion, economic condition, work, etc. Even the famous leader and the father of Indian constitution, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, he was also the most known leader of Dalits. He also faced untouchability and discrimination. At the age of 9, he faced untouchability and discrimination on one of the railway stations. At the age of 9, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, he faced discrimination. A nice incident, it is described in our textbook. So when you get the textbook, you read it. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, as he faced discrimination, so he decided to fight against it. And in constitution, he mentioned, he removed the untouchability from India. So discrimination, many of the times it divides the country, it divides the society, it creates havoc in the society. So this discrimination we have to avoid. The practice of such behavior which gives birth to discrimination, that we have to avoid. Another point, that is striving for equality. As many people face inequality, many people face discrimination, so they strive for equality. These people, they were Dalits, women, tribals, even peasants. They were deprived of certain rights, they were discriminated, so they strive for equality. The Dalits, they demanded entry in temples. In ancient time, in those days, the Dalits, they were not allowed to enter in temples. So these people, they demanded entry in temples. Women, they were deprived of education. So women, they demanded right to education. Tribals, they were deprived of different rights, certain rights. So they demanded some of the rights. While keeping in mind all these demands, finally in the constitution, there were provisions made which helped these people. According to Indian constitution, all the people of India, citizens of India, they are equal. Irrespective, no discrimination can be taken place. All the citizens of India, they are equal in the eyes of law. Irrespective of their caste, creed, religion, gender, etc. All the citizens, they are equal. In our constitution, it means from India, untouchability is demolished. This is about The second chapter, diversity and discrimination. Quick recap. In the beginning, we have studied about differences, that there are differences in India. 8 major religions of the world, they are found in India. 1600 languages, they are used in India. 100 dance forms, they are available. People differ from their attitude, their food, their clothes, etc. Besides that, we studied two terms, prejudice and stereotype, that resulted into that leads to discrimination. When we judge people negatively or see them inferior, lower, then it is prejudice. When we fix people into one image and act accordingly, we create a stereotype. Discrimination and inequality, they were found in India, and the Indian constitution has tried to remove them. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, when he faced discrimination, untouchability, he did his best to remove it, and he was successful. And finally, according to Indian constitution, untouchability, that was demolished. Thank you, students.